Because leading worship actually is how we enter the presence of God, how we have a close relationship with God. And, you know, this close relationship is built up by a heart of faith, really believing that God is present all the time, really loving God, honoring God, put God in the first place, and spending time to pray. Spending time, not thinking of it as waste. You know, I prefer prayer over many things, but because of my, you know, my calling as a teacher, a trainer, so I have to write, I have to continue write. But if not, like today, because I did not bring my computer, and it was very hot because in the house there was no electricity, but I kept praying for a long time. That's how I am. And I hope you have this heart, and to see how God is real, how God is, you know, can bless us when we have this close relationship with God. I would like the principal, it's okay for you to come and share, because this morning I went to the school, because she saw the work of the Holy Spirit and she experienced it herself. And to share, to encourage you how real the presence of God is. Although you all know that, but it's encouraging to hear that. And I hope that you would do this, to say, yes, Lord, I want to have that presence of God in me too. I want to have that anointing in me too, to bless people. I tell you, it's something that I continually build up also. It's not something that just happened to me. It took time for me to build up the anointing of God. And it takes the heart. Actually, I treasure the relationship with God more than anointing. It's the relationship that I really treasure God. I really like God. I want to be with God. I enjoy God. I like everything about God. And I hope you have this heart. When you have this heart, no matter what happens, you will continue to love God. So I would like the principal to come forward to share. Hallelujah.
Is it okay if you open so there's more ventilation? Is it okay?
Yeah.
Please.
I greet you all in the precious name of my Lord and Savior Jesus.
Amen.
Thank you so much for Pastor Hill and Pastor Fenayomi.
I asked you to speak louder so the recording.
All right. Is that better?
Yeah, this is much better.
Yes, they came and blessed us in the morning. We always have the morning service for the teachers before we start going to the classes. And this was one wonderful day when we were blessed with two pastors. We were so happy. And what they did today, I have never experienced. We experienced the presence of the Holy Spirit. It was so real and so tangible that I thought I was walking on air. And most of the time when you want to call down the Holy Spirit, it's so difficult because of the things that you have and the things that are in your heart. But this morning, we were taught how to do it and how to concentrate and how to really feel the presence. And the children were so amazing because when they came for prayers every Tuesday, we have prayers for children that have got problems. So we called them from the classes. They came, there were more than 100 students. And when they came in, most of them, when we went back to the class, they said there was something which was, you know, a child would always say the exact thing that they felt, that they were floating. And I felt the same thing, like I'd been lifted up and I was somewhere else, and it wasn't something that I have ever experienced before. So this morning, and it continued during the day, and that where you concentrate and you continually call the presence of the Holy Spirit, I found it real. We were so excited. Thank you very much.
I'd love to share what some of the teachers shared briefly.
Yes, we had a number of teachers that also experienced. Some of them went through deliverance this morning. One of them had a heaviness in the chest, and she couldn't even lift her hands. But after she was prayed for, she started coming up, and you could see this was deliverance through the Holy Spirit. Another one also came up. She had dreamt in the night, seeing somebody with the same haircut. And you know, it was so interesting. And he was really blessed. this one said, I saw. And when I came here, I saw you. And I knew for sure you are the man of God. And I believe she also afterwards, she said she was also delivered. Because these are some of the things that we were asking God, that this is a time when we want tangible results, and we had them this morning. The others just went jumping. They couldn't stop smiling. And I asked, what's the problem? No, since morning I've been having a joy that I cannot explain. It was very, very, very good. And we were so blessed this morning. And we even told them they can come back again. And tomorrow we want to be early so that we can experience it again and again and again. You are blessed to have them. Thank you so much.
Glory to be to God. This is totally the work of God. And the thing I want to say is, this is how we bring transformation to a group of people. That we can see a group of people change and transform and a life used by God. So it's something is very real and very powerful. So I hope that you would hunger for that. Don't say that, no, I don't have the talents, I don't have the anointing, I don't have the power. Don't say that, because it's God, it's not us. You'll be surprised that when you pray more and then you start praying for people, you'll receive amazing results. You know, actually, I have a number of students in Hong Kong, and they also learn to pray for people. And one woman was a, what do you call, a remodeling worker, a woman. And, you know, she didn't have much education. And then she experienced the Holy Spirit, and she became very free. And she went to different places, and she also went to Nairobi. And she was helping some people to experience the joy of the Lord. So what I'm saying is, you too can carry the power of God. And the point is, one day you'll go to heaven and see the wonderful plan of God in heaven being so great for you. But many people have wasted their life and only used their life to a small extent compared to what God planned for you. Would you say, oh, I didn't know it. I should have followed God more. And when I see, it's most important thing, because one day when we go to heaven, we see that the most important thing in the whole lifetime is how we follow God, how we obey Him, and to be used by God, right? One day you see, wow, money, housing, marriage, and all these things really are not the main thing in life. The main thing is that you follow God's plan. When you follow God's plan, you have everlasting results. And you see people saved, you see people transformed, and you go to different places, you glorify God, and God say you're a good and faithful servant. And that really is most important, because God will remember you. God knows your heart. When God sees your heart, He will bless you. He knows who, you know, who likes Him, who loves Him. And actually, this teacher said she saw me in a dream. This is not the first person who saw me in a dream. That there were a few people, at least three I can remember, three other ones that saw me in a dream before they met me personally. Yeah. So that's a recognition from God to say that He knows me, so He conveys that thought to the people. And also God also told people and said, you learn from Pastor Yip. Actually, people heard that. You learn his life. You follow him and learn from him. And to me, I really feel honored, also humbled. I must say I'm special. I'm saying that God chose me when I was weak. God chose me and gave me power and gave me the anointing. Of course, I did pay the price. I did spend a lot of time praying. Let me tell you, when I first experienced the Holy Spirit, there was a cupboard that I stand in front of to pray, and my hand touches it. And I didn't know that. After a while, there were two marks there, two marks of dirt, you know, stuck to the cupboard. And my wife saw it and said, what is that? I said, oh, that's my hand's mark on the cupboard. that I preached so much that it left two dirty marks on the cover. And that's, you know, the most important thing is that we can be used by God, and you will never, never regret it. And you say, that is the best decision I have ever made in my life. Do you want that to happen to you? That's the best decision I've made in my life, that I'm willing to dedicate my time to God, my life to God, and serve God. Because this has everlasting results. The most important thing we know is food and money and marriage and the different things are just the duties on earth. They are not the purpose of life. Those are just our duties. The most important thing in life is whether we follow God's plan. Because in Colossians, it says that we were created by Him, by Christ, through Him, and for Him. For Jesus Christ. We were created for Jesus Christ so we can glorify Jesus. Glorify God. But many people, I'm sorry to say, many people lived the perfect plan of God only to a very small extent and did not wake up. And I hope you wake up. I hope you wake up and say, God is so wonderful. God is so good. God is so loving. You know, in my heart, I always think about the wonders of God, how wonderful He is. I always love Him. I always like Him. That is the key to my life, to my spiritual life. It's, I really like God. I really like everything about Him. Everything He does is so beautiful. Now, one verse I want to read to you. In Isaiah chapter 30, verse 21. Isaiah 30, verse 21. There it says that, whether you turn to the right or to the left, your ears hear a voice behind you saying, this is the way, walk in it. So it says that you, when you go to the left or to the right, you'll hear a voice saying behind you, this is the way, walk in it. So this is talking about the work of the Holy Spirit, that you will hear the voice of God telling you to go which way. Now, we have talked about the love of God in these last few days. I always talk about the love of God. And this is another verse that we can see the love of God. How do we see the love of God here? Now, pretend that this is you. This is you, okay? So God will talk to you in a year. This is the way. Walk in it. When you turn to the right, say, this is the way. Keep going. Or turn left. And you go the other way, He will keep talking to you. Go the other way or keep going. What does it mean? It means God pays personal attention to you. God pays personal attention to you. He sees you as someone very special. And He's willing to spend time with you. As I said, the verse that you have quoted, listen, hear me quote many times, that in that He is in front of us and behind us and is laying His hand on us. In Psalm 139, verse 5. So He's always with us. He sees us as someone important, that He will spend time with us and He will keep talking in your ears, guiding you. The more you obey Him, the more He will talk to you. When I pray, I often hear ideas from God. God will tell me ideas. And when I'm teaching too, God will give me ideas. Like this morning too, when I went there, God spoke to me too. God guided me what to do. How to wake up the people. Because before I enter, I asked Pastor Evans, what is the condition of the teachers? And he told me honestly that 1/4 of them are not Christians. And so I have the heart of evangelism. And at the same time, I have the heart of revival. I want to revive the spiritual life. I want to tell them each person is you know, very precious in the sight of God, and God is a wonderful plan, and God is so real. So I preach the message of God is very real, and He can come to bless us. And God guided me, because very often, I tell you, sometimes I go to a meeting, I don't know what I'll be preaching. I have all these ideas. I have verses in my memory, I have verses on my sheets, but then sometimes I don't know what I will say. But God will guide me. to that. At the time, He will guide me. And He will guide you too. That means He pays special attention to you, that you are very special. Can you tell the person next to you, you are very special. You are very special. That God pays special attention to you. That God pays special attention to you. Now, there are different responses of people. They'll say, okay, good, God pays attention to me. But let me tell you, try to respond to God with your whole person, including your mind. Remember, I talk about the spirit and the soul. The soul includes the mind, the will, the feelings. So we respond to God with our mind and say, wow, this is wonderful that God would pay special attention to me, that we are special in His eyes, that He would speak to me. So with the mind, that our mind is changed. In my mind, let me tell you, in my mind, I've made up my mind that God is the best. And people are, in my life, is people are people, you know, are what I want to bless. I want to bless the people. But I don't expect from people. I don't expect to get things from people. I just bless people. But for me, my attention is in God, not in people. But I do pay attention to people. I do love people. You know, I spend time praying for the teachers. There were maybe, how many teachers this morning? 50, 60. And I was told I had 20 minutes to preach and I prayed for them. So I went very quickly, but later the principal said, you have more time now. And but, you know, also, you know, ask God how to manage this. But God will give us wisdom, and I have the heart to care for them, to love them. And when one of them had this bondage, I would care about her and I want to have a deliverance for her. And I'm always willing to bless people. But my heart, whenever I have, you know, I put down my meeting, immediately I will spend time with God. And even now, I will spend time with God. So I hope you say, God is so wonderful. My mind will totally respond to Him and say, He's the best. And make up my mind. The first is the thinking, and then the mind, the will. Yes, Lord, I dedicate my life to You. I dedicate my life to You. My time is Yours. My life is Yours. My fun time is Yours. I play tennis for fun. I go to walk with my wife for fun. We go to different places to take photos. But on the way, we'll be praising God. But a lot of people say, pray for a long time, 1 hour, 2 hours, 3 hours, is no fun. When we think that way, then it's no fun. But when you think of God is so loving, He's so wonderful to me, He's so good, He's the best that can happen to me, I want to spend time with Him, then you make up your mind to follow Him. I hope you say that. Yes, you know, you have seen people here sharing in the last few days how they experience the Holy Spirit. I'm amazed how God works. And when I see that, I respond with my mind, this is wonderful, with my will. I want to dedicate my life more to God, even though very hard today. I find a place, normally I would close the door and have air conditioning. Thank you for Pastor Wycliffe that he gave me the special room with air conditioning. So I stayed inside to pray. But today, inside there was very hot. So I went outside. I went to a place that I can keep praying. And I don't see it as a burden. I see it as something I enjoy and like. So my mind, my will, and then my feelings. I hope you remember this. When we handle our life, we handle our mind, our will, and our feeling, and our spirit. And my feeling is, I like God so much that I want Him more than anything else. That I, you know, today is, you know, no electricity at the house for a long time. And I ate, you know, what did I eat before I came? I ate white rice. I also ate some other food. But because of the refrigerator is out and then no cocaine, so I ate the white rice. But I like it, no problem. Because I like God so much, I don't mind. Actually, Pastor Wycliffe has prepared so much food for us. It's just today there is no electricity to heat it up. And I thank him for really treating us very well. But my heart is really for God. I like him. When I think of God, I feel sweet. Sweeter than with my wife. My wife always gave me the feeling of sweetness. You know, today, for so many hours, electricity was out. My wife waited for me. But then, you know, she knew that there must be something wrong. My wife here. And she knew that there must be something wrong. And then she went to sleep. But then, at her time, 12:20, she woke up and saw my message. And then she called me. I mean, she has to wake up early in the morning to go to work. But yet, she was, when she saw my message, knowing that the internet works now, then she immediately called me. That's how sweet she is. But God is sweeter. Then he will spend so much time with you. So I hope in your heart you say, Jesus is the best that can happen to me. Would you say, Jesus is the best that can happen to me. He can use my life. He can make my life beautiful. Amen. He can lift up my life to a high plane. That I can go on clouds. Oh, yeah. That I can be blessing people. Amen. I have blessed so many people. The principal just said that she felt like floating. I've heard so many people said they felt like floating when I prayed for them, even on the phone. And I said, you too can have that power. So, are you touched? Do you respond with your feeling? Or did you say, no, it's just you. No, I have no interest. When I go home, I'll just think about my money and my food, my family, and worry about my life with emotions. That's how I live. Or do you want to live in cloud nine, floating all the time? I have God. It doesn't matter. Nobody can do any harm to me. Which way do you want to live? Do you want to live like earthworms?
No.
Struggling through problems all the time?
No.
Or do you want to live in cloud nine, floating in heaven? It doesn't matter what happens on earth. The most important thing that my life is used by God. Is that important?
Yes.
I hope you will say that's important. And also put it in action. How many of you have spent a long time praying today? Now, I'm not trying to embarrass you. You just answer your question yourself in your heart. How many of you spent a long time praying today? After you've seen the work of the Holy Spirit, do you respond by really desiring to pray to God? Really desiring to have a close relationship with God, to enjoy God, to love God. You know, when I pray to God, I think of enjoyment. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. It's for sure that God brings joy and peace and comfort. So it's comfortable to stay in the presence of God. It's comfortable. The more you pray to Him, the more you experience God. Today, Rachel, the household worker, asked me to pray for her. She says she has stomach ache. And I prayed for her. And she said she felt power enter her whole person. And then later she was filled with joy. At first she had pain. And then I told her to lay hand on the stomach. And then later it went away. And I told her to continue to stay in the laughter, the holy laughter. I hope she will. There's so many times I've seen people and prayed for them, they experience the Holy Spirit, and I said, please keep the anointing. I told them so many times, when in a meeting, please, when you go home, don't just walk around and talk and do other things. You know, when I went to Spirit-filled meetings, when I went home with my members, I don't talk. I tell them, I talk later. Now I want to pray to keep the anointing. And I hope you'll be praying and loving God in the heart. And then always spend time in concentrated prayer and also spend time, whatever you're doing, that you spend time to love God, thank God, hallelujah. Right now, when I'm preaching to you, I'm also enjoying God and think about God and His presence with me. So respond to God, remember? Tell me, the soul includes what? The mind. You should write this down if you have pen and notebook. I encourage you to bring your pen and your notebook. Your mind, your will, and your feelings. And then also your spirit. That the whole person. So I told Rachel today to love God from the bottom of her soul. And she cried out, hallelujah, and then the joy started to come to her immediately. It's so amazing. So hope you will continue to live in this close relationship with God. Now today I'll talk about leading praise and worship. Now some of you are worship leaders, some of you are not, but it doesn't matter. Because this will help all of you in your prayer life and in your worship life. It's most important to realize that leading praise and worship or praise when you are participating in praise and worship, it is not just singing songs or dancing. I know some of you really like special dances. Okay, it's good. If it makes you feel free to worship God, it's fine. But if you just look at the steps, see, I have these steps. If you just look at a step and forget about God, then you're not worshiping, you're just dancing. So it's very important, first, as worship leaders, that we want to develop this relationship with God. A very personal relationship with God. Let me use an illustration. For many people, when they pray or worship, they'll think of God far away. I encourage you to think of Jesus as like a friend. If He's your friend, you'll think about Him more. Like a friend you know on earth. Then, when Jesus did all these things to you and give you the power to pray for people and experience all the blessings of God, and then you think of Him as a real person, then you would think about Him more. But so very often, people pray like this. Hallelujah. It's like praising to the air. Thank God. Hallelujah. It's like praising to the air. Not thinking of a personal God. When you think of a personal God, real person, standing in front of you, oh Lord Jesus, you're so good to me. Thank you, thank you. Now even though some of you, I know each one of you experience the Holy Spirit to a different level, it doesn't matter. But I hope when you see other people experience the Holy Spirit, you say, He can experience the Holy Spirit like that. That means one day I can experience Him stronger too. And also means that He is very real. So whatever you experience, you still say, it's so wonderful, so good, and it can happen to me. And also, I want to tell you that, even though some people don't feel anything, it doesn't mean they don't have anointing. Sometimes they still do. You just keep praying, and then you pray for people, you'll be surprised that you carry the anointing of God. The most important thing is that you really treasure God, and think of God as someone most special, someone the best that can happen to us, that God is so honorable, so beautiful, so wonderful, that you like Him with all your heart. With all this saying, I'm saying, please learn to like the Lord. Please learn to appreciate God. And like to enjoy Him, like to build up a relationship with Him. That you really see Him as someone very special. In the book of Genesis, talk about Enoch. Walked with God for 300 years, and then God took him away. 300 years. What did he do? The Bible did not say. But he was probably praising God, loving God all the time. He was walking with God all the time. It doesn't mean that we walk with God and one day God will take you away. But it just means that this person is a special person, that God used him to illustrate that. One day God will take us to heaven. So God used that with this person and also with Elijah, that he was taken up into heaven. That God wants to show us that the relationship with God will reward, will bring rewards, blessings on earth. Okay, we look at some Bible verses that talk about praise and worship. Psalm 22 verse 3. Psalm 22 verse 3. Now you don't have to turn to the Bible because you just write down. We don't have time for that. I'll read it to you. But you are holy, O you that dwells in the praises of Israel. That God dwells in the praises of Israel. When the people of God praise Him, God dwells in the praises of the people. So this verse is very important. When you praise God, when you're thinking of God and loving God, it's very important. When you praise God, you think of how wonderful He is. I hope every day you think of how wonderful God is. Do not think of, today I go to church to worship. Don't just think of, I go to church. I go to church to do it. Think of, God is so good. I like Him so much. I like to worship Him. Think of not just a church activity. Don't just think, okay, I go to church now to praise and worship. But think of a personal God who is so loving, so nice, so kind to us that I want to praise Him and worship Him. You get the point? It's not just going to church. It is meeting God, having a relationship with God. When you praise God, when you love God, His presence will come real. His presence will come strong upon you. His presence, you can feel His presence. Actually, most people experience the presence, the peace, and the joy of the Lord. How many of you experience that? Please raise your hand. When you praise and worship, how many of you experience peace, or joy, or love? Thank God. But there are levels of experience. There are levels of experience. You experience peace and joy, that's wonderful. But you can experience it to such a degree that you are overwhelmed with the joy and overwhelmed with the presence of the love of God, and also that blessing will pass on to people. I have done spirit-filled meetings many times, and people told me something like this. When I was talking, people felt power come to them. When I was praying, sometimes I did not lay hands. People around me just felt the power of God, just felt the presence of God. And sometimes people just fell down or started to cry, started to laugh, filled with the holy laughter. That the presence of God can be so strong when we love God and honor God and like God and put God in the first place in your life. Do you like that? One time, one of the sisters in my church in the past said, she was standing next to me, but she did not see me. You know, she was facing the other direction. And I walked over to that place, and she was standing there, and then suddenly she felt joy. And she said, why? And then she looked around and she saw me. Oh, that's the reason that I was there, and then she felt the joy of the Lord. That we can be carrying the presence of God like that to people. And I'm not saying, you know, I'm special. I'm saying God is special. So God can dwell in the praises of Israel, the praises of His people, that you really, every time when you praise God, hallelujah, I like you, Lord. I like you. I love you. I like you. I want to be with you. I hope you have this attitude. It's most important to develop a strong heart of liking God, that we like God. When we look at all the things and say, God is so wonderful. God is so beautiful. Everything God created is so beautiful and so wonderful. Our body is created so wonderful. And God works in my heart and speaks to me, to my ears, to guide me, go this way or go that way. That when we think about everything God has done, then we say, God is so wonderful. And then in your heart, you're full of gratitude. Are you full of gratitude?
Amen.
Anytime I think of God, I'm full of gratitude. I'm full of a heart to like God. I really like God. I like my wife very much. She's really the perfect mate for me, that she loves me so much, she cares about me, and she has wisdom.
Amen.
Sometimes when I talk with some people or counsel some people, when she has time, she will come along. And then I ask her afterwards, what did she hear? She would tell me what she has heard, something I missed. She would tell me. She's very wise. And my sermons, you know, many people like my sermons, but my wife can suggest to me how I can improve. And I see this as a gift. I don't see it as a criticism. And she said say it in a way of building me up. I appreciate it. I said thank you, because that's how I can improve. If not, I'll stay the same. And when people stay the same, they gradually they go backward. So I thank God for that. So I really like my wife, but I like God much more, because God blesses me in so many ways, much more than my wife can bless. And actually, the blessing of my wife came from God. It's not from me, it's not from people, it's from God. That God has planned this for us. When we follow God, when we seek first the kingdom of God, and then He will give us all these things. Okay? Another verse, Psalm 145, verse 18. The Lord is near to all who call on Him. To all who call on Him in truth. So when you call on Him, the Lord is near to you. So when you praise and worship, He is near to you. Now, when this verse says that He's near to you, and also another verse that you probably know this verse, James chapter 4, verse 8, come near to God and He will come near to you. What this verse says is that when you come near to Him, He will come near to you. When you call upon His name, He will come to you. That means He will come stronger. I mean, if we all have God with us, if we are true Christians, so this verse that you come close to Him, He will come close to you, it means a stronger presence. In 1 Samuel chapter 10, verses 5 to 10, talk about Samuel talking to Saul and say, go to a group of prophets. You see them praising God with instruments. He did not say praise God, but that he would play instruments and they would be prophesying. And then he said, when you go there, you'll be changed to a new person. And then you do what you should do at that time because God is with you. Now, God's presence, there are a few kinds. One kind is God is with you. It's anywhere. The omnipresence of God, God is anywhere. The second is God is with the believers. Now, if Samuel is talking about God's presence with the believers, then he would say, go to any Israelites, any believing Israelites, and then God is with you. But he did not say that. Go to that group of prophets who are praising God, who are prophesying. So he's saying, this group of prophets have a strong presence of God. And God's presence will be stronger. So here it says that, when you come close to Him, He will come close to you. That is a stronger presence. When you call upon Him, He will come to you. A stronger presence. When you like God, His presence will come stronger. When you appreciate God, His presence will come stronger. When you have God with you, the best will happen to you. The best. Let me tell you, I came from a very poor family. When I was young, I ate rice that is rotten with mold on it. You have to wash away the mold and then cook it. And very often, we just put soy sauce in the rice and eat it. And we don't have fish or vegetable. And one reason is because my father was a gambler. So there was not much money in the home. And so then, you know, we were short of money. And, you know, my stepmother really put a lot of effort into keeping the family having food. But very often we don't have much food. I came from that family. But when I believe in Jesus, when I know that Jesus is God, there's real God, I really follow Him. And when I have income, I start to tithe. I did not wait for the pastor to remind me. When I heard the sermon, the teaching, I start to tithe. And God blessed me. God gave me the opportunity to have one bachelor degree in Bible college and two master degrees in the seminary to give me the chance to learn a lot so that I'm prepared to bless other people. So when we love God, God will plan the best for your life. He will make your life go higher and higher. So it's best when we worship God more and for the whole day, then His presence will come stronger to you. When you have a strong presence of God, you have all kinds of blessings. The reason why I can go to different countries to bless different countries is because God provides for me. If not, I won't be able to go to so many places. It's very expensive. And actually, very often we bring gifts. We bring gifts to the churches to help them. And God has given me so I can give. And if you dedicate your life to God, He will also bless you. He will bless you. He will open the way for you. I know one person, he went to the United States to study, but he had an accident. In the accident, the lung collapsed, and he had a danger of dying. And then he said to God, "Lord, if you save me, I dedicate my life to you." And then God saved him. And then he went back to Hong Kong. He has a dream of building Christian schools, and then also helping Christian schools to reach out to the students to have a good witness. But he had no money. But he just had the vision. And he told people the vision, and then he got enough support to build the first school. And I was a teacher in that school. So I had a chance to see him, how he has the dream of reaching out to students with the gospel. And in that, when I was there, actually I was a new Christian when I was teaching there. I was just a Christian for 3 years. But I was teaching the students, I have Bible study with them, I have classes to help them to believe in Jesus, and I took them to the park to do evangelism. I was very active like a pastor, but I wasn't trained even at that time. That God, you know, when God sees your heart like that, then God likes it and He will bless you. He will open a way for you. So don't ever think that I'm not qualified. The first thing is be courageous. You know, so many times I ask you to come and share. This would increase your courage. Among my students in Hong Kong, sometimes some of them are afraid to come out to share. But the more we did it, the more they're willing. Like today, they just had a meeting, and I'm away from my training session in Hong Kong. And I was told there were 5 people, they were willing to share, what came out to share. I hope here too, if you want to be used by God, you want the presence of God, but you also want courage. You want to have courage. Okay, and then 1 Corinthians chapter 6 verse 17, a very important verse. 1 Corinthians 6 verse 17, it says that, "But he who unites himself with the Lord is one with him in spirit." Listen to this again. "But he who unites himself with the Lord is one with him in spirit." Now here it talks about unity with God, one with Him in spirit. Some people say, well, all Christians are one with God the Holy Spirit. Yes, you are. But there are different degrees of unity. Some people just barely touches God. Just barely. Maybe a few minutes a day they pray. A few minutes a day they think about God. But some people have a closer relationship. They pray more. They obey God more. But some people will go to an extent to say, "My life is yours. I dedicate my life to you. I want to think about you all the time," like Enoch. He walked with God for 300 years, always thinking about God, always loving God, praising God, obeying God, to have this unity so that our heart becomes the dwelling place of the kingdom of God. Your kingdom come, your will be done. That means not only we ask for the kingdom of grace that more people are saved, but we also, our heart becomes a place where God rules totally. God is the Lord totally. God is the King totally. Then you are totally in unity with God. When you are totally in unity with God, He will speak to you all the time. He will guide you all the time. He will use you all the time. He will direct you to help people. I tell you, there are many people, they have problems. And God directed them to look at YouTube. And they looked and saw me. And then they called me up. There are many people, about once a week, someone would call me from somewhere. And then said they saw the video and they want to We need to pray for them or help them spiritually, or they want to be trained to serve the Lord. So God will guide these people. And also God told some people, you learn from Pastor Yip. So God will guide these people. God will open a way for you. Sometimes we think, how much I can do? But God will open the way for you that you can do greater and greater things. The school can become greater and greater. The teachers will become all Christians. And as students we transform, many of them will become ministers. When you have the presence of God so strong and all the teachers having the life of Jesus so strong that students say, I want to be like him. I want to be like the teachers. When we are like that, then your life will influence the people around you. Do you want to be like that? Hallelujah. So I hope that we all hunger for God. So when we lead praise and worship, it's very important. First, think about loving God. Don't think about music first. When you think about music, you think of expressing your love to Jesus. Now, in a praise and worship, what can we do? First, you personally praise God and love God from your heart, from the heart. So I encourage you to learn to cry out from God, from your heart to God. Hallelujah! Thank you, Jesus. Do this every day. Hallelujah! All the whole spirit rises to God. Hallelujah! Praise you, Father. I love you, Father. I want you, Father. Hallelujah! So learn to do that. And then when you lead praise and worship, you will really enter praise and worship. And then the next thing is, we can use words to help people. Words of grace, prayer of grace. For instance, saying, oh, God is right here. God wants to bless us. God has made up his mind to bless us. God wants to do great things in our life. Hallelujah! Let's praise the Lord with all our heart. We need to have instruction. Don't just sing. Don't just sing. Give instruction. Let us open our heart. Let us jump to the Lord. Hallelujah. We want to love you. And then we participate ourselves. We ourselves do it. And also do it with feelings. Write this down. With feelings. Because when we know God is so good, we want to respond with feelings and with the Spirit. Imagine when you were young, you met a very wonderful boyfriend or girlfriend, will you tell all your friends if that person is so wonderful? Will you? Then you will really want to tell people that your life will show that how you are happy with that person. So when we lead praise and worship, don't just lead praise and worship. Tell people, our God is very wonderful. He's so loving. He's so good. Don't just say it. But tell people how good he is and have prayer of grace. Remember this prayer of grace always declaring, God is loving me. God is blessing us. He's in front of us and behind us. He's laying his hand upon us. So first, we will have instruction and we'll have a prayer of grace. And then you will respond to worship, to love. And when you praise and worship, don't just sing. Say it. Oh Lord, I love you. Oh Lord, you're so wonderful. Hallelujah, I love you. I put you in the first place in my life. Response with your voice and with your emotions. Hallelujah. Now, later I will talk to you about voice. When you hear my voice, do you hear that my voice is very solid, very firm? Now, even when I talk softly, you can hear it clearly. And also, I enunciate the words clearly. Each sound, I say it clearly. That's something we all should learn, how to pronounce it correctly. You can actually go online, onlinedictionary.com or other dictionary online, and learn from the pronunciation to say the English words correctly. If you say it in the African way, only Africans can understand you. But if you say in a universal English way, whether it's British English or American English, then people all over the world can understand you. Then you can speak clearly and also resonance. I'll talk about that in a moment later. Resonance, how to have resonance. But first of all, then you respond with emotions, with feelings. Oh Lord, you're so wonderful. Hallelujah. Praise you, Father. I love you, Lord. Hallelujah. So here I talk about three things you can do. You can give instruction to people from time to time, and then you can have prayer of grace and declare the goodness of God. Declare the goodness of God and also prayer of grace. Oh, God is so wonderful. God thinks about each one of us. God is talking to us. God is guiding us. God is attracting us to come to Him. So declare the grace of God and have prayer of grace. Prayer of grace means like, oh, the Lord is loving us now. Thank you, Lord. You are caring for us now. You are with us now. And then the third would be praise and worship to God. Father, we love you. Oh, hallelujah. I love you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. And then when you speak or when you sing, sing with feelings and emotions and freedom. And be free with your body. When you lead praise and worship, be free. Be free not just to dance, but be free to express and to enjoy. Hallelujah. That everything, it shows not just music, it shows our love for God. Now some people lead praise and worship, it shows music. It's good too. But what we want to show is not just music. It shows our heart of love for God, appreciation of God, and enjoying God. Okay? Now I'm going to demonstrate a moment to lead praise and worship. And then I will have you do it in tunes or three to do it with the other person, to try to do this three kinds of ways. Let's say this with me. Let's stand up, please. Say this with me. Now, declare the grace of God. Something like this. I will say it and then you say it. But you can keep your eyes closed and say it with feeling. Oh, the Lord is right here. Say it. Oh, the Lord is right here. Now, can you hear my voice as feelings? The Lord is right here. Right here. Now, I heard some people talk, no matter what they say, it's always the same tone. The Lord is here. Thank God. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. It's always the same expression. Try and put feelings into it. Hallelujah. The Lord is right here. Say it.
The Lord is right here.
The Lord is in front of me and behind me. He's laying His hand on me.
He's so wonderful.
He looks at each one of us with love. He's really happy to see us come to worship Him. Now listen how I say it. He's really happy to see us come to worship Him. Say it with me. Happy. He's really happy to see us come to worship Him. Our Lord is a loving God. Let's come to Him. Let's open our heart. Now this is instruction. Let's desire God. Hunger for God. I need you, Father.
I need you.
Now, this now is the response to God. Oh, I want you, Jesus. I love you, Jesus. I depend on you. You are my life. You are my strength. Now, I don't mean that you say this for 5 minutes. Actually, you say it once in a while. So the three kinds of words you can say, you know, declare the grace of God. He's right here. He's blessing us. And then instruction. Let us open our heart. Let us hunger for God. And then we do it ourselves. And then we do it. We say, Lord, I love you. I want you. I need you. I worship you. I adore you. Okay? Now I'm going to talk a little bit about resonance. In order to have resonance, first you have to have breath. Then you can, you know, relax your chest, and then inhale without raising your shoulder. Inhale, try.
And then inhale, without raising the shoulder. Expand forward and sideways. And then keep the air there by holding the cage, the lung cage, firm. Because if you let it shrink, then you lose air. But you keep it. Then you can, you know, then you can practice this at home. Practice this that you can sing for a long time. The resonance is like yawning. Let's try to yawn. Do you notice it's in the back? Now really make it sound like a real yawning. It's so big in the back. Notice when you open back, it's like this. Now open back. Then you can. The air, you use your abdomen with strength, pushing down or pressing in, and so that when you sing high notes, if I don't use this breath support, when I sing the high notes, I cannot do it. So you practice every day, yawning. You yawn and practice that. And then air has to go up. Don't go forward, it's up. It's going up. And then you can hear the whole place resonate. That's resonance, but it takes time to learn it. But you just pay attention to how to do it when you practice at home, you keep doing this yawning exercise. Notice how you're opening inside. Try it. Are you opening inside? It's opening the inside of your mouth, inside. And then you have the strength. Then when you sing high notes, you can still have strength and have sustenance, that you have the strength to continue. So the first thing when you sing is to make the notes continue. Instead of saying hallelujah, you say hallelujah, continuous. The sound will continue. Hallelujah. There's no gap in between the notes, okay? Right now, I'm going to lead worship, and one person go up and play the key of G, and in a key of G, and follow me. Who plays the keyboard up there? Anyone up there? No one's here now? Oh, he's gone. Okay. Let us now close our eyes. And keep standing, because we're leading. I'm leading praise and worship right now. And then you, at the same time, you try to enter the presence of God. At the same time, you notice what I'm doing. You notice how I am declaring the grace of God, how I'm giving instruction, and how I'm worshiping and loving God. And also when I sing, how I use feelings. Oh, hallelujah. Please keep your eyes closed. Hallelujah, oh hallelujah, thank you Jesus. Thank you Jesus, you're so wonderful. Oh, play the key of G, Hallelujah, Lord Jesus. We worship you, we adore you. You're right here now. We want to come to you and adore you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
master, you play with us now. Jesus right here. Jesus is right here blessing us. He's standing in front of us and behind us and laying his hand on us. He is blessing us right now. You say, Lord, I accept your blessing. I receive your blessing. I need your blessing. I hunger for your blessing.
Just stay, ha ha ha.
sit down.
Oh.
Hallelujah.
Excitement.
God, there's just a bubbling within me. What comes within me right now as we're worshiping Him? Songs. He's singing that. I feel the Holy Spirit singing back to me. He gives me songs like that. That is how I stand in worship. You know, I can come up with songs. Songs can keep coming like that. So as the man of God was, he started, I just felt, you know, it's like, An air just came, fresh air just came into my belly. So I just felt emptiness within me, very free like that. That's why, you know, I was just worshipping, I was just getting close. And the more I concentrate, the more I usually say to my team, right now just focus on Jesus. Nothing else, that's what I do. I make sure I focus on Him, and no one, I just found myself, Him singing back, laughing back to me, and then giving you songs that you've never heard. That is the nice part of worship, when you've opened up your spirit. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So that is what I felt, just that air, power air, hit my belly, and Lord started just visualizing the love of God, see His beauty, His goodness. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Anyone want to share? What did you come? What's your experience? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory to God.
Glory to God. First of all, I just want to say to you, Pastor Pastor Wendy, she's a leader for praise and worship. She's been telling me before, I've seen God telling me, you're a worshiper. Hallelujah. My pastor, she's been telling me, you're a worshiper, but I've been denying it. I've been like, seeing worship, I've been like, I was denying it, and so quickly I'm really sorry. When I was praying, I feel like, I hear like light air coming inside my body, but it's too much hitting my baby. So from now on, I will worship the Lord in truth. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Anyone else want to share? Now I want to ask you, have you noticed how I led it? Have you noticed how I led it? I was mingling instruction. Let's worship the Lord. Hallelujah. And with voice of excitement, with feelings. Or say words of grace. Oh, Jesus right here. Declaring the grace of God. God is blessing us. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. And then I will respond right away. It's very important to learn to use, you know, the voice is very important. So practice your voice every day. And put in your energy and feeling, and then you can be used by God greatly. Now, does anyone want to come out and try a little bit? Now you can do it, actually, you know, time is short. If one person want to come and do it, and I will give a response to the person, or you can do it split into groups of two and then try to lead the other person. Does anyone here want to try to come out and, you know, just sing hallelujah, whatever, a simple song, and then and lead the praise and worship? Does anyone want to do that? And then I'll, okay, come on up. Hallelujah! Praise the Lord. Any simple song you want to put?
Sing, it's okay. And keep it short so that we have time, because we only have about 15 minutes now.
Amen. Okay. Amen. Worship principle
what this, it's a miracle effect. You can get your healing and everything. Me, this is how I do it, even when I'm sick. I can say Jesus the whole day, I don't know how many times. Jesus, 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 it's all about you, Jesus, in my life. It's all about your goodness, your mercies. I just sing until when I have no other word to say. Mm-hmm. I'll keep saying, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. I tell you, a miracle happened.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Oh, you shared that. Okay.
Okay. Just to give a testimony of how this works, I love worshiping God. I'm not a good singer. I'm not in prison. I don't have that voice of singing. Amen. But I know, even when I'm sick or I've lost something, I misplaced, I start worshiping. The moment I worship, the presence of God comes. The Holy Spirit begins to speak to me and will guide me to the when that. Let me tell you a miracle that happened. A few months ago, I was so sick, it was an emergency. The doctors were saying there's a stone, it was trapped in my bile duct. They wanted to fly me to South Africa. And I said to this doctor, wait, he says, wait for what? This is an emergency. You cannot, that stone has to be removed. I said, wait. The whole of that day, I kept saying, Jesus, you are my strength. You are, I kept worshiping him, calling him all the beautiful names that I can go. I kept falling in love. And love with him, and that stone dropped him.
I was asking, does anyone want to come out and lead worship, a short worship, just very short, and try to lead people into the presence of God?
Amen.
Hallelujah. And please stand up. Are you leading or you are?
I want to lead.
Okay. And then I will give you a response too.
You are so good. You flow nicely. I'm not so good like that.
It's okay.
But I will try. Yes. Hallelujah. Yes. Amen. We can stand. Hallelujah. You can feel free in the presence of the Lord. Lift up your hands. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We give the glory to Jesus. We are worthy, Lord. You are worthy, Jesus. You are faithful, oh Lord. You are faithful.
Yeah. Thank you. Please be seated. Now, let me ask you, because we are learning, so we evaluate. How would you develop yourself just now? And what do you think you've done well? What do you think you can improve?
I think I've tried a little bit. But if I can continue just worshiping the Lord in prayer and praising Him, I can go as far as I can sing. Even people will receive their miracles. Hallelujah.
As far as what you just did, what you think you did well, identify what you did well, and then identify what you can improve.
As far as what you did just now, this is a learning process, so we can say, okay, this is something we did well, and then I can keep doing, and this is something we can improve. Can you think of?
I think I forgot to talk to them first, to usher them in worship. I guide them, maybe I quote even a verse. I forgot to talk to them first.
That's okay. We don't have to talk to them first. It's up to you how to reach. Okay. Now, as far as the length of what follows, what do you think? The length of the encourage them, and also the content. What do you think?
The good thing you need to know: worship must be part of your life. It must come from within you. Hallelujah. When you are worshiping God, you have to forget everything about your life, what you have been maybe going through during the week. You have to focus unto the Lord. Amen. And you worship Him with all your heart, with all your strength, and with all your might. Amen.
Okay. I'm going to give some comments. The reason is because this is a learning process. He did. Now his voice, at a certain point, has strength. That adds to it. That's very important. You know, use voice like this. Hallelujah, praise the Lord. You know, that sometimes he has that strength. Now we can have different kinds of voice. Like for instance, we can have gentle voice. Oh Lord, you're so wonderful. I love you, Lord. And then we can have voice of excitement. Hallelujah, praise the Lord. So you can mix it together. But when we are gentle, try to be gentle and soft. Oh Jesus, you're so sweet. When we are saying those words, try to lead people into it. You're so sweet, you care about us all the time. And use real examples, even in praise and worship, in sermons too. You're so real right here. You give us peace. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. So mingle soft words and excited words that convey the feelings. And also, I would say that the end part when you try to pray, it could be too long. When it's too long, what happens is some people can get into it. Some people might lose. Then you can sing. Don't make every section of prayer too long. Then it will become like a prayer. But the prayer can be shorter, but yet you mingle it with other things. Like you can say, oh, thank you. You're so faithful, Lord. Although we are not faithful and you are always faithful, we want to appreciate you. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. You're so faithful. Immediately response. Don't go too long, but really bring into the responses. You see. Now this kind of training, it takes time. Actually, there are so many things I can train. You decide, you know, if you think it's something good that we do tomorrow again, or as some other training. I have so many training that I can do. But if you like to, you know, you can vote on it and tell me and then what you want to do tomorrow. But we have time for one more person. Does anyone want to come forward and lead a short time of, you know, praise and worship, and then I'll respond again for you to learn. And in a singing, in the middle too, if you learn a song well, in the middle you can
put in responses like, oh, hallelujah. And also learn spirit songs. Yes, Jesus, hallelujah. Oh, Jesus. Then you have to practice at home. It's just come with the spirit. And so what I'm saying is that you can, in a singing, hallelujah, thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Now notice the voice quality is very important, right? Have feelings in it. Not just sing, but with feelings. Hallelujah. Oh, Jesus. Okay, anyone else want to? Anyone of the worship leaders want to come and practice right now? Last chance. One person. Okay. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah, church. Let's rise up on our feet. Let's worship the Lord in the house. Hallelujah. God is wonderful. Hallelujah. He's a great God. He's a magnificent God. Hallelujah. I just want you to picture Him right now, to envision Him. And let's worship Him. He's the great God. He's a wonderful God. He's a magnificent God. Hallelujah. That's something that I always want to work on, so that I take this God, let the people see the God that I'm worshiping. Yeah, I have to leave that path. That's the path. Then the emotion, also you talk about the emotion. We have to show emotion and the feeling to the people.
Wow. Let me ask you, Chinese, say something with emotion, feelings. Hallelujah! Praise the Lord!
Hallelujah! Praise the Lord!
More energy.
Hallelujah! Hallelujah!
Hallelujah! Praise the Lord! Hallelujah! Praise the Lord!
Okay. Thank you. Another thing we want to learn is to, when we say worship, you say worship, worship, people might not care. We have to use simple ways to guide people. For instance, we can say, oh, Father, you're so beautiful. We want to worship you, adore you. We love you so much. You're so important in our life. So use different words to help people to have the concept of worship. You just say worship, people keep saying five times, worship, we worship God. Hallelujah, we worship you, and people may not get it. It's, you know, it's something we need to learn to be creative. Now, try to say this with feelings, like Francis, listen to me. Oh, Lord, we worship you. We adore you. You're so beautiful. We want to kneel down in front of you. We want to say, Lord, you are my God. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Now, see how I put feelings in there. And use different expressions to show it. Can you try a little bit? Be free. Hallelujah. Yeah. Like a bird.
I normally do this and use my ass first to get to you. Hallelujah. Oh Lord, you are wonderful. You are a glorious God. You are a magnificent God. We just want to worship you today. We just want to bless your holy name for your good works in our lives. Jehovah God, you are magnificent. You are awesome in the midst of us. Who can compare unto you, God, in the whole universe, you are God. We bless your holy name this evening, for you are the great God. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Okay. Now, it's good that you use different expression and try to be more real and personal. Oh Lord, you're so beautiful. I adore you. So it's like really pouring out the Spirit. I adore you. I love you. It's so wonderful to have you, Lord. It's come from the heart. And also work on the voice, having strength, the revival of the voice. You notice that when I speak, it's sometimes, oh, wonderful. Sometimes it's excitement. Hallelujah, praise the Lord. The Lord is good. Oh, hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. So change the tone and will be something we can practice at home. Okay? That it's something for us to keep working, and God bless you all.